Good morning, everyone. I am Rebecca Williams, Chair of the Union County Board of County Commissioners, and I'd like to welcome you all today and thank you for this opportunity to speak at this morning's networking breakfast in this beautiful space. I want to acknowledge some folks who are here today. Hi, Tanya. Vice Chair Chris Hudak is in attendance. Commissioner Al Mirabella. Commissioner Sergio Granados is here. Our Deputy County Manager in charge of economic development is here, Amy Wagner. Also, our coordinator of the Office of Business Development, Jeff Brooks, is here. And Phil Candle, who is our Director of Strategic Planning, is also in attendance. The Union County Means Business Initiative was designed by Commissioner Mirabella several years ago to bring local business owners, prospective owners, and managers in contact with information and other resources to help their businesses grow and thrive. And some of you may note that Dina Maceros, who had run this program for a number of years, she's moved into a different area, still working with us at Union County, but I do want to acknowledge all the years that Dina put into making this event a success. It really is essential to have an outlet where Union County business and government leaders have an opportunity to meet and discuss economic development, especially as we're really hoping to be out of this pandemic. Most importantly, everyone here shares common goals, working together to strengthen our community and set a firm foundation for future growth. Our county, Union County, is in a very fortunate position. We are a core transportation hub with close proximity to Newark Airport, the seaport. We have direct links to several major highways, trains, and we're closest to, of course, New York City, one of the world's, probably the world's biggest leading economic center. But our greatest asset truly is and remains our people. We're diverse, we're energetic, and we are a team that is constantly growing. Business leaders are not just CEOs of their companies and small businesses. They're also economic leaders in our country. There are a lot of people here who care very deeply, I know, about the future of our county and this country. And over the last 2 years, as we have navigated through the pandemic and a difficult economic period, we have made progress. And the reason we've made this progress has been because of the outstanding management and productivity that you all have been able to achieve in your own organizations and companies, and your willingness to move forward and to build. So we're all here today to bring people together, put our resources together, expand our customer base, and enhance our communities. There are programs and services that can help support local businesses, whether you're just starting one or whether you're already operating, there's information here for everyone. In the end, we all care about making Union County a place where you can plan, build, expand, and prosper. And together with my fellow colleagues on the Board of County Commissioners here, we will make sure that you can connect with all the available resources so that you can continue to succeed and thrive. We do have a printed program, and you can see all of the partners who assist us in these efforts. So now, it is my pleasure to introduce today's keynote speaker, Kean University President Lamont Repelet. I have known Lamont for many, many, many years, since the early years, the humble years, when he was president at Carteret High School, down to being the superintendent at Asbury Park, moving on to the state, where he became the first African-American to serve as the head of the Department of Education, and now as the president of this outstanding institution. And I just wanted to add a couple of additional notes. So his entire bio is in the program, so I'm not going to belabor all of that. But it was really through Dr. Repelet's leadership, along with our chair at the time, Chairman Al Mirabella, that Union County was able to forge a partnership, a groundbreaking partnership, forming the first proprietary county and academically run COVID testing lab, the first in the nation. So this changed our ability to get testing results from days, as you all remember, by getting tested and waiting days, to a matter of hours. And we will be recognized this year at the National Association of Counties, at the National Convention. We will be receiving the NACO, the 2022 NACO Achievement Award. So again, this is really important, really groundbreaking, and it would not have happened had it not been for the leadership of President Repelet, the Board of Trustees, and the county. I think that's all I have to say. I really do want to hear what Dr. Repelet has to say. So without further ado, Dr. Lamont Repelet.
Now, I'm struggling with the new name. I love it. Commissioner, director, I wasn't quite sure if it's director, commissioner, director. But just do know that you are the boss lady of the county, so I'm going to sit and say that, right? I want to welcome everyone to Kean University. As I look around the room, I see some familiar faces. I have to just shout out my boss lady over here, one of our board of trustees, Bertha Little Matthews. Hey, Bertha, how you doing over there? She's a pillar in the Union Township community, so thank you, Bertha, for coming out here. And more importantly, thank you for supporting us. I'm looking at the elected officials, but more so looking at my friends, the commissioner. They're very supportive of the work that we're doing here at Kean. Always the continued support, but more so the support you've shown me over the last 2 years. I can honestly say it's incredible. And Rebecca talked about the partnership. So today I'm going to talk about a couple of things, but it's more so the tenets are going to be on partnership and resources and support. And I think that's important. So I'm going to get to that, but I really want to just shout some people out real quick. And I'm also going to have Rafael Monta doesn't know this, but he's a director of our Small Business Development Center. He's going to come up here almost like a shameless plug. Because I want him to really talk about, that's the resource part, to really come in. I'm going to talk, then I'm going to have him come up here. So if you want, Rafael, you can sit over here if you can. So when it comes in, it can almost be like a stunt person coming in. And he's a lot handsome, a lot thinner. So I'm okay with that, you standing in as me. But I just wanted to make sure. But also just business folks here, elected community leaders, elected officials, thank you and welcome to Kean University. It's a great day. And I was joking on the side. I said, Al Mirabella, he's slick. I ended up my board meeting yesterday, so that means it's the last board meeting of the year. So I'm officially off for a few, but Al was the only one to get me in a suit the day after the board meeting, so thank you. But this was important. I know that we've been trying to find a mutual date, but this has been important for us at Kean University. So a few years ago when the pandemic hit in 2020, I was the Commissioner of Education, serving under our great governor, Phil Murphy. His mantra and motto was a stronger and fairer New Jersey. You know, and he always talked about the strong piece being the economic. But I didn't make the connection at the time. Because as a commissioner of education, my focus always say, stay in your lane. Talk about what you know. You're the expert in education. So I was always focused on education. But I wondered, why is the governor, he has me on every economic task force in the state. So I go in and sit there, and I'm like, I'm sitting there like, wow, these folks are a lot smarter than I am. They know about economics. They know about small businesses. But the light bulb hit. It hit because we're the ones that are creating the workforce. And I did not realize that, right? Because, and K-12 sometimes, and also in that space, you get kind of the understanding you're preparing these kids for college. you know, we say college and business and career readiness, but it's really more so preparing them for college to go on. But I didn't realize that that opportunity, that space between high school, whether they go to the military, the workforce, do they have the skills to be successful? So that was one epiphany. So I'm sitting in a room during a pandemic, health crisis, and the governor's trying to decide what buildings, what organizations, what entities will remain open, right? What first responders, what essential businesses? The first thing you talked about, sitting there with Tim Sullivan, you know Tim Sullivan, Economic Development. Tim said it's important that we have our small business continue to operate. And then they started going around the room and saying, well, who's gonna for our first responders and our essential employees, who's gonna watch their kids? How are we gonna move stuff in and out of the state? That's been a light bulb for me, because we're talking about a health crisis and the governor is talking about keeping the state stronger. And he talked about the importance of small businesses. That's when I realized. And during that time, I was transitioning or going through the process, right, of becoming the president. I kept it quiet, going through the process. And I said to myself, if I ever sit in that seat, we're going to just really emphasize small businesses. Because if we're talking about economic development, we're talking about a stronger and fairer New Jersey. It starts with you. It starts with elected officials creating policies and procedures to make it easier, right? The practices that we do, the resources available for folks to be able to recruit individuals, to be able to give them the skills to upskill those individuals. And then it talks about resources available. So as a university last year, I'm going to thank Craig Coughlin Jr. here, as he's our director of governmental affairs, along with my chief government affairs office, Kelly Ledet. We hosted a small business program that would get local businesses involved in the bidding process at the university level. And we know that small businesses normally don't have the political capital to build on large-scale projects, but they do have the essential workforce, the team, and the talent to bid on projects that are less than $100,000. And if you have projects less than $100,000, that can be a great year for you. So we made sure that was important. And so most recently, we're in the process. Kean has a small business development center. And we hired a dynamic individual. And one of the charges for him is that, what are you doing to support businesses? How can, as a university, partner with you to build your company to make sure that you are serving our community? Because that's the most important piece. Because if we go back to the governor, a stronger, fairer economy starts with small businesses. So he's going to talk about, I'm going to bring him up right now to talk about our Small Business Development Center, because I am proud of the fact that we have a Small Business Development Center on campus. But I'm more proud of the promise of what's going to happen. I'm proud of the partnership of the small businesses, the county level. I just want to just shout out the county. Amy, the work that you're doing, you along with our trustee Ed Oatman, is amazing. You know, and we've always had a strong partnership, but I think that we've taken that partnership to the next level. I mean, to be recognized as a county, to actually serve at a higher institution, to be able to provide services for the county is very important. So thank you very much for that. So right now we'll bring Raphael up real quick. Raphael, you have 5 minutes. You have actually 3 minutes, because I still got to talk about what we're going to be doing here as far as economic development at Kean University and the work that we're doing.
Wow, no pressure at all, right? Just 3 minutes to talk about what's going to be the first of its class Small Business Development Center in the state of New Jersey. I'm very honored to be working with President Repelet. We have crossed paths before, very briefly. I have worked in county government. I've worked in state government. I've owned businesses. I was in the heat of the pandemic, dealing with problems on the front line, Union County being one of the most responsive counties that I dealt with as I tried to access resources. You guys quickly took on federal resources and gave access to small businesses that didn't register properly, that didn't know how to maneuver the process that could only respond to you via phone and don't know how to use computers or email or things of that sort. So I commend you on that. Now, in regards to what President Repelet is referring to, how many of you know about the Small Business Development Center? How many of you heard by show of hands? Okay, that's a decent amount. How many of you know that we've been around for 45 years? We don't market too well. But what we are is a large network of 11 educational institutions, this being one of them. I am very, very excited to be under a president and a dean, Dean Wong of the College of Business and Public Management, who are talking about integrating the students into small business services and creating project-based internship programs, doing certifications for businesses on site. And I'm talking about certification walkthroughs, not us telling you how to do it and then you go home and the kids get you or the other job responsibilities get you and you never get around to it. The college is going to be open to businesses. We're going to be doing a lot of innovative things here, things like teaching you how to write an RFP, how to price your products correctly, actionable educational items that businesses can apply right away. I'm a firm believer that workforce development is economic development, which is what President Repelet is talking about. I think you're going to see that this university is going to integrate that like no other. Not to knock any of the other ones, but I'm Team Kean, and that's going to be number one. Anything that Dr. Repelet is doing is going to be number one in my book. We are the Small Business Development Center. Corinne is our new operations manager. Many of you may know Vanessa, recently promoted to business services manager. We're looking to be more accessible. We're looking to leverage technology. We're available via Zoom and Google Meet and all that great stuff. All right. You'll see a larger capacity. And I'm very happy to announce, no disrespect to my union people, we also serve Somerset County now. So the expansion has already happened. We realize that our focus is union and Somerset, but we have our eyes on a state and regional economy as well as a global economy. So our focus is on these counties, but opportunities could be from anywhere. Thank you very much. I hope I didn't exceed my 3 minutes because you'll take it from me later.
Thank you. See, I'm a firm believer, stand in your lane, right? So obviously I wanted him to come up here, Rafael, the regional director of our Small Business Development Center, to kind of give you a snapshot and a forecast of the kind of work they're going to be doing. So now here we are. We have a vision. We have leadership to support this economic development in the state. So we now have a Small Business Development Center to provide the resources. So now the third part of this triangulation for us is our university academic piece. And we talked about early skills for our students. But I'm proud to say that last year we put in for a grant. You know, sometimes you go out there and you cast a wide net. We applied for the U.S. Commerce Economic Development Grant, which will provide an opportunity to provide economic development in three regions, South Jersey, Central Jersey, and North Jersey. Now, to me, it was a long shot because if you look at the region in which we were accepted or involved in, it included major Division I or Tier I research universities. So that means Rutgers. So for 20 years, Rutgers University held this grant. However, not knocking Rutgers University, but it kind of focused in one area in North. Our grant application, thanks to the work they were working with in a partnership with the Watson, John S. Watson Institute of Public Policy and Research, which is now housed here, we are the policy arm of 32 urban centers. That means we are the policy arm for the New Jersey Urban Mayors Association. So when Rafael talked about the reach for us at Kean, it's real. Our goal, as my chief development officer, our cougar paw, our prince, will be all over the state. So we crafted a proposal to provide economic development in South Jersey that focused on agriculture, Central Jersey that focused on advanced manufacturing, and then North Jersey that focused on small businesses. And guess what? We awarded the grant. I'm going to clap because I'm going to tell you what universities received this grant. In Virginia Tech, Delaware University of Delaware, Maryland University of Maryland, Pennsylvania, Lehigh and Penn State, New York, Cornell and I believe Stony Brook, and New Jersey and Connecticut University of Connecticut, and New Jersey, Kean University. So for me, that goes to show that you have this vision and you cast a wide vision to be able to support the state. That was very attractive to them. So now, how do you connect the academic piece to that? That's the most important piece. So we create a Center for Social Entrepreneurship. That's going to be focused and housed out of our College of Business and Public Management. Our focus there is to create these leaders, these thought leaders, to be able to go back in their communities and be innovative in thought. Be problem solvers for urban centers, right? And truly take the word public architecture, public business, public health to the next level to understand that our job is to collaborate, co-labor, right? Collaboration is co-labor, to work together to solve problems. So for us to be able to fuel this economy, this engine, and then make it go, we need you. We need you to hire our students to be interns. We put an emphasis this year on career services. Because the goal for me is that I want my students to have the skills necessary to go into the workforce in day one and compete. Because the one thing about our students here, we're talking about, we are 46% first generation students at Kean University, 76% of students of color. The county we serve is a diverse and proud county. So we're going to make sure that our partnership with all entities will produce Union County as the economic hub, because right now they think it's Middlesex. No disrespect, Craig Coughlin Jr., right? Because Rutgers got the hub, right? But we want to make sure that Union County, as Raphael says, stand up. So we're already encroaching in Somerset. We got our eyes across. Not because we're greedy, because we're going to do it the Union County way. That Union County way is working together. So today, if nothing, please, you should be harassing Raphael and his team. And if they're not getting back to you, you call me. You email me. Because I talk about equity in action. I just don't like talking about it. My team will tell you. I like doing it. Right? So I hope that today serves as a starting point for us to build this relationship so you can look at Kean University as the epicenter when it comes to all things Union County, whether it's academics, whether it's economic development, whether it's cultural, whether it's athletics. It is our job to make sure that, and I promised my board of trustees when I was going through this process that we will be that beacon on that shiny and that top of that hill, that when folks saying, I need something, I have a question, come to us. Because if they turn you down, you come to me. Because we're servant leaders here at Kean University. And our partnership has proven that. We're the only third university in the state to process COVID sample labs in our facilities. And we're probably very one in the country didn't have a medical school. It's Rutgers, it's Princeton, and it's Kean. My mother always say, birds of a feather flock together, right? It's the company that you keep. So I'm talking about Rutgers, Princeton, and Kean. And then I'm talking about this economic development proposal we got, this grant from the U.S. government. I'm talking about these tier one schools. So that goes to show you that Kean University is leading the way. We're hanging out with folks that we will look at and say, wow, that's a strong institution academically. We're changing the narrative here at Kean University. We're no longer looking to be a small regional university. We're looking to be a national university. So when I got here in day one, I talked about, you know, becoming a research university. And everyone in the interview, I thought they looked at me like I was crazy. So I'm known for coming in interviews and doing something that's totally different. When I walked in Asbury Park for my interview for superintendent, I bought a box of hard hats. Imagine that, right? I found out later on that the president of the board said, is he in a wrong interview? This is not engineering. I brought the hard hats as a symbol of the hard work we're doing. You know, when the governor announced me as a nominee for Commissioner of Education, I gave him a hard hat. I said, I'm going to be putting the work in. We have hard hat pins to symbolize the hard work that we're doing. And not everyone get a pin. You have to earn a pin. So please, we want to earn the pin for you. Look at Kean University as the economic, culture, and athletic center of Union County. And if you do that, then I promise it's going to be a great partnership, because we already got a model right here. A model right here that's award-winning, actually. So before I, I'm going to end on this one here. So last week, a couple weeks ago, the Governor Murphy and Mayor Adams of New York City had a watch party at Liberty State Park. The World Cup was announcing the winners of the North America sites for the World Cup. So we got a phone call a week before saying, we would like to have your signage. We want you to attend this watch party. Because they was here looking at our facilities, you know, to see if we're a fit. So needless to say that the World Cup is coming to New York, New Jersey area. Needless to say, Kean University will be a practice site for that. Now, look how that's going to drive up the economy in this area. Because let's say we do get the big game, the championship game, and they might play a semifinal, which is probably four teams or eight teams. So just imagine, we're a facility practice site. Where are they going to eat? Right here. Where are they going to train? What are they going to do? Right here. Where are they going to stay? Right here in our county. So we got to be prepared in 2026. So we will be prepared for this. For this infusion of these talented individuals coming here. And we got to put our best foot forward to show them that the County of Union is open for business. But it's about excellence. Right? And the key that we talk about at Kean University, everything we do, I always challenge my team, is that excellent? We look a certain way, but is that excellent? We want to make sure that we create an excellent small business development center. We have a good one. But can it be better? Yes. And I'm going to continue to push. In our College of Education, are we going to produce our students? Yes. Our kids go on to some of the amazing schools, but we're going to push them to be excellent. We're going to push them and take them out of their comfort zone. So I say this, we're going to push you. Move you out of your comfort zone. Because we want you to be better. Because if you're better, our students are better. So welcome to Kean University. Thank you.
Okay, folks. So that was really rousing. I hope that you're all fired up with the news of the FIFA, right? The World Cup, right? FIFA. I'm sorry. I don't play soccer. I don't watch soccer. Although I was in Paris in 2016 when they won, and it was crazy. So that said, I want to again thank the county and all of our partners here. I want to thank Dr. Repelet for his incredible speech that really, I think, is a blueprint for what we need you all to do in partnership with the county and with Kean University. There's still a little bit of breakfast, there's a little coffee, and let the networking begin. Thank you all.